This video is going to demonstrate how to use Autodesk Inventor's presentation environment to record an assembly video. I'm going to start with this vacuum flange clamp assembly here. It's got like 9 different parts. It's made out of aluminum and steel and a couple different things, and so it's ready to go. I've got this assembly fully complete here. I'm going to start by coming in here and saying let's create a new presentation file, and then it's going to ask me right off the bat what do I want to insert in there. It's going to be this vacuum flange clamp assembly, so I'll choose open. And you'll notice now that we're in the assembly or the presentation environment that there's some new stuff going on here. Of course the tools are different, but then down here at the bottom I've got this storyboard panel. If you're working on a computer that has 2 different monitors, you can move this storyboard panel tape, say, over to this other monitor so that you can have, you know, a full screen here to work, and then you can have the other screen showing your storyboard. Otherwise, you can dock it down here at the bottom, and you can adjust the size of it so that you can see more or less of your storyboard as necessary. I'll set it up about like this so that it's ready to go. So what we want to do now is we want to take this thing apart and record the taking of it apart, and actually we'll record it in reverse direction so that it's showing it putting it together. And what I'm going to do is, just as an overview, I'm going to take this wing nut off. There's a washer under here. I'll take the washer off. I'm going to swing this collar open 90 degrees so you can see how it works. We'll remove the little pins that go in here that hold it all together. There's a link on the other side over here, that piece. We'll take that link out, and then we'll take this screw out, and then we'll make a few other tweaks along the way as well. So in order to move the components, you use the Tweak Components tool. And what I'll do is I'll just choose that wing nut there. I want to tweak it up in this direction, so I can just grab that arrow, click and drag, and then I can tell it how far up I want it to go. So I'm going to make it go up 2¼ inches like that. Okay, so it's 2¼ inches off the screen. And then I also want to take this washer and I want to move it up out of the way as well. So I'll go back to Tweak Components. I'm going to pick that washer. I'm going to pull it up, but maybe not quite as far, about 1⅞ of an inch there, just to get that up out of the way. So now at this point, if you wanted to, notice that you can look down here at the bottom. See, there's my wing nut and there's the moving it out of the way. And then there's my my washer and moving it out of the way. Each one's taking about 2.5 seconds to move. If I wanted to right now, I could simply just play it back and see how it's going to go together. So the washer goes in place and then the wing nut goes in place. I know that it doesn't quite look right just yet because that wing nut needs to turn. We'll address that closer to the end. If I go to this end here, you know, I want it to end up there close like that. But then once we get out a little bit and we go to, say, this end, I maybe want it to back up a little bit so we can see it like that. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to change my view in this, and I'll just say capture this camera right here. And so now notice that it says capture camera here. I've got this new part on the timeline. So if I were to play it back right now, you'll see what happens is it's moving that washer in and that nut in at the same time, which I kind of want it to stay, you know, at this level here before it moves in. So the nice thing about this camera is you can drag it wherever you want it to go. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to let it move that washer in, and then the nut and the camera are going to zoom in at the same time. So see how the washer is going to go in there, and then the nut and the... So I kind of get that nice little dynamic change at the end there, which makes it kind of nice. So now from here, the next thing we want to do is we want to swing this thing open, say 90 degrees. Again, that's on Tweak Components. The thing that I want to tweak is this upper collar, but I don't want to move it, I want to rotate it. Now, right now it wants to rotate around this point that's kind of like the center of mass, but if I choose the Locate tool up here, I can instead come in and say I want it to rotate around the center of that pin. So you'll notice how it moves that little icon, the gizmo over here. Then I can say let's rotate this up, and I can say let's rotate it up 90 degrees just so that it looks kind of normal, and then enter. So now there we are with that. And then we want to take and we want to move that up as well to engage it. But before we can do that, we need to take out these pins. There's one, two, and there's three pins that kind of hold this thing together. So we'll tweak those and we'll move those all at once just to show that you can do that. So I can say I want to tweak this one. If I hold the control key down, I can pick that one. And if I stretch it over here, I can pick that one. Then I can say, let's move all of these out this direction. I'll move them out, say an inch and a quarter to get them out of the way. So then from there, I can now move this up an inch. Okay, so if I say tweak this component, I'm gonna move that up an inch. And I can also move this little link up, and I'll move it up a half of an inch so that it's kind of rotating or sitting in the area there, 0.5. So now here we are, you can see how we're getting more and more complex of things going together in this video. Again, if I play it backwards, you'll see how it's gonna kind of go together here. So the link goes in place, then the upper goes in place, my pins are going in, all right. However, if I go to the end, if I zoom back to the end here, notice how I've got some space here at the bottom, but I don't have any space here at the top. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna double click my mouse just to give me some more space at the top, and I'll do another capture camera here. So now what it's gonna do is it's gonna capture this camera. So if I say, okay, let's play this back now. Notice how it's moving, you know, in at the same time. So it's moving a little closer. The thing is I don't really want that to happen here. I want it to maybe happen back over here a little bit more so that I can see the things that move in place and then move. So I'm gonna take and I'm just gonna drag this back. I'll drag it back to say like right here so you can see what we've got. So if we go to the end, so now if I say, okay, play this backwards, notice how it kind of keeps a nice margin all the way around the end. Then when that gets in there, then it starts to kind of move in again so that we can kind of see how that works. So the last thing that I need to do here is I need to move this pin out or my screw there. So I'll say, tweak that out. I'm gonna take this and pull it out in this direction. I'll move it out, say like 3/4 of an inch. And we're pretty much ready now to go, except I don't like how it takes and it puts all three of these pins in at once. See, ideally what you do is you'd put the screw in and then you'd put that pin in and then you'd move the link in and you'd put that pin in. So these elements down here in the storyboard are completely adjustable. So what I want to have happen is I want to have this screw go in, which is this piece, right? And then I want this pin, if I pick it here, notice how it highlights it down here. I want that to go in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to move this over here and I can just click and drag that. And then I'm going to move this out. It makes my movie a little bit longer, but that's okay. So now notice that the pin's going to go in. I can just kind of drag through it. The pin goes, or the clamp screw goes in, and then the pin goes in, and then the link goes in. So then the next thing that needs to happen is not the upper part coming in, but then this pin needs to go in, okay, which is this one. So I'll move that one over like this. However, I don't want this pin coming in and that coming down at the same time, so I'll click and hold control, and I'll pick up all of these and move them all now out to the end here. So now you can see how it's gonna, if I go to the end, and I just kind of drag it back in here, you'll see how it's going to put this thing together one piece at a time rather than moving all of those pins in all at the same time. So now I can see that I need to probably move this back over here a little bit so that it's not, makes a little more sense. So I can have that zoom in as that comes down. That actually looks pretty good like that. And then the pin goes in. And then the last thing is this comes down and at the last minute, we'll have that screw go into place. So the last thing that we want to address is that this needs to turn as it goes down onto the screw. So what I'll do is I'll just click on that again. I'll say, let's tweak this component. Again, it's not going to be a move, but it's going to be a rotate. I want it to rotate in this direction, okay? And I'm going to give it a rotation angle of 1080 degrees, which makes it go around, you know, quite a few times, but it still starts out with the proper orientation. Notice that when I choose OK and I put this in here, that it's what it's done is it's stacked those two right on top of each other. If I double click right here, I've got my move and my rotate at the same time. Okay, and if I were just to play it back right now, you'll see that it starts rotating at the very top and then it finishes down there. But I don't actually need it to rotate until it gets right above here. So what I can do is I can adjust the length of this one and I can pull it back here to maybe just like the last second it's actually going to rotate. So if I hit replay now, it moves into place and then just at the last second it's going to show that it can actually move. So now we're pretty good. The only thing that I might want is a little bit more time at the end to just kind of show, you know, if I get to here, I want it to sit there and just show you the assembled part before it ends the video. So what I'll do is I'll just say, let's just take all of these things right here, and I'm just going to do a shift, and I'm going to drag these over, say like an inch or so, or excuse me, like 2 seconds. And I'll drag this one over to 2 seconds as well. And then I'll get the rest of these and I'll line them up with that one. So what I've basically done here is I've given it, you know, the video, you know, is going to end over here, but the last 2 seconds are just going to be a little bit of time for you to look at it and kind of process what you've got. I could do the same thing by adding another camera angle over here at this end and just extending this out. So our final video is going to look like this, and I'll pull it down so that we get a better view of what this is going to look like. I'll hit rewind and you'll see how it's going to move the first pin in, or the screw in, then the pin, the link goes in, and then the second pin, it zooms up a little bit, the third pin goes in, it closes, the washer goes into place, and then finally then it waits for about 2 seconds before it's done. So that's your video. So now what we want to do is we want to capture this actually as a video. So you'll go to the video tab up here and you'll say, what storyboard do I want? Right now we only have one storyboard, but you can make as many storyboards as you want. You can make them all record, or you can do them one at a time. I'm going to play it in reverse so that it's showing it assembling rather than disassembling. And then right here I can pick the video resolution. Rather than doing current document window size, which would be this, I would pick one of these down here. You know, like 16:9 is a nice aspect ratio. It's common with many computer screens these days. But these down here are very large. They're going to make gigantic movies. So I'm going to pick one up here like 800 by 600. It's not quite, it might chop off a little bit of my margins, but just for the sake of doing this video, I'm going to show you that here. I'll give it a name here. I'll call it the vacuum flange clamp. Okay, and make sure that it's saving it in the right place, which it is. And then finally, instead of a Windows movie file, I'm going to save it as an AVI. Choose OK. Right here, if you want to compress it to make it smaller, you can pick whichever codec you want. I'm just going to leave it full frames. It shouldn't be too large. Probably be around half a meg or so with this. And then you choose OK. And then what it does is it basically records this like 30 frames per second. So it takes a little snapshot of each of the elements in all of their different positions as it goes through. The longer your video is, the more pictures it has to take, the more memory, you know, it's going to take, the more space on the disk your movie's going to take. But if you're just doing an 800 by 600 like I am, and it's 30 seconds or less, it shouldn't be too large. So then it tells you that it's done. And when you are ready to watch your video, you can simply find your video. In mine, it's right here, that vacuum flange clamp. And if I just say, let's watch this now, you see how my, I've got 800 by 600. So it's not quite showing me exactly the same size as what we had on the screen. It's a little pixelated because I didn't, you know, it's not the big size, but it's going to be a great movie to show somebody how this thing is supposed to go together. There you go. And that concludes making a video, an assembly video using Autodesk Inventor.